हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नीलाचल पॉलिटेक्निक। माई सेल्फ अमरेंद्र मिश्रा गोइंग टू टीच यू द सब्जेक्ट स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल। हियर इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द सेकेंड नंबर चैप्टर ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट। द नेम ऑफ सब्जेक्ट चैप्टर इज थिन सिलेंडर एंड स्फेरिकल सेल। These are the contents related to second number chapter, introduction, definition of thin cylinder and spherical cell, stresses developed in thin cylinder as hoop stress, longitudinal stress, calculation of hoop strain, longitudinal strain, change in diameter and length of thin cylinder, calculation of change in volume and volumetric strain, hoop stress induced in spherical cell, hoop strain and change in diameter of thin spherical cell. Let's go for the introduction part. In our engineering field, we are coming across different types of vessels of cylindrical and spherical shapes containing fluids such as pipes, tanks, boilers, compressed air receivers. Generally, these above vessels are very thin thickness as compared to their diameters. These vessels, when empty, are subject to atmospheric air pressure at its internal and external surfaces, such that the resultant pressure on the walls of the cell is zero. While we are going to use these vessels for supply of water or liquids or gases, during this time the pressure of fluid is acting along the internal surface of the vessels. Due to this internal fluid pressure, the walls are subjected to tensile stresses. And here we'll go for study that the different stresses developed in the thin cylinder due to internal fluid pressure. Before calculation of stresses developed in thin cylinder, first of all we have to know that what is thin cylinder. A cylinder is said to be thin cylinder if the thickness of cylinder is 1 by 10th or 1 by 15th of the diameter. If T is the thickness of the cylinder, D is the diameter of the cylinder, now the thickness of cylinder T should be less than that of 1 by 10th or 1 by 15th of diameter. Generally, thin cylinders are used as tanks, boilers and receivers. Generally, these thin cylinders are carrying or store the fluids such as oil, water or steam under high pressures. As shown in the figure, we are having a container. This container tank stores the fluids inside it. This is the pipes. These pipes are used for carrying the liquid or gases from one place to another place. As we know that the fluid inside the cylinder is at high pressure, so This may cause the failure of cylinder. If the withstanding capacity of the cylinder is less than that of the pressure of fluid inside it, then the failure of the cylinder takes place. So what are the failures are there? First failure is that the cylinder is splitted into two troughs or two halves, and another is splitted into two cylinders. As shown in the figure, we are having a cylinder is subject to internal fluid pressure and it is not withstanding the high pressure of liquid. Now it is formed into two halves. Troughs means two halves or two half cylinders. So this is the figure of failure of cylinder into two halves. Now in the second figure we are having seen that the cylinder is converted into two numbers. These arrow marks are the resistance offered by the material of the cylinder. These edges, there are some arrow marks are there. These edges are providing the resistance to that of the internal fluid pressure. These arrow marks are known as your internal fluid pressure. As we know that due to internal fluid pressure, the cylinders may be filled into, splitted into two halves and splitted into two numbers. So there are two types of stresses are developed inside it. So one is hoop stress or circumferential stress. Second one is longitudinal stress. As shown in the figure, we are having A to B is known as your length of cylinder. This is the three dimensional figure of cylinder. We are having the sigma 1 and sigma 2. These are nothing but the cylinder is along the horizontal direction. So there is a stress acting along the length. Also there is a stress acting along the diameter or circumference of the body. So while the failure takes place in a thin cylinder, during that time there is a failure takes place along the circumference and that causes the cylinder into two halves. Again, this also causes the cylinder into two numbers. Now this red color arrow marks are known as your resistance offered by the material of cylinder to that of the force exerted by the high pressure fluid inside the cylinder. So while the cylinder is converted into two halves, this red color arrow marks are known as your resistance force, and that will not allow the cylinder to failure into two numbers of halves. Again, in the second figure we have seen that these arrow marks are causing that the cylinder should not be filled into two numbers, and these are the resistance force along the length of the cylinder. These arrow marks are known as your internal fluid pressure. Let's go for derivation of hoop stress and longitudinal stress produced in a thin cylinder. Before that, let us consider a cylinder having diameter D, L is length of cylinder, T is thickness of cylinder, P is internal fluid pressure. We are having two types of stress developed in thin cylinder, sigma C, circumferential stress, sigma L, that is your longitudinal stress. As we know that due to the internal fluid pressure is much more higher than that of the withstanding capacity of the cylinder, so it causes the cylinder into two troughs as well as splitting the cylinder into two numbers. Let's go for calculation of hoop stress and circumferential stress. So due to the high pressure of fluid, the cylinder is now converted into two halves. This is the figure of one half of the cylinder. So while the internal fluid pressure is acting along the circumference, this is the circumference of the halves, one half. So these aromars are known as your internal fluid pressure. So while the pressure of liquid is acting along its diameter during that time, if the pressure is much more higher, then it will causing the cylinder into two numbers of cylinder halves, and the edges will be have the resistance to that of the failure. The failure takes place at the edges of the half. From the top view, we will see the edges of the trough. Now we'll see there are two rectangles are obtained. This is the thickness of the cylinder, and from this is your length of the cylinder. The cylinder should be in safety condition. So during this time, the bursting force or pressure force should be equal to that of the resistance force offered by the material of the cylinder. The pressure force is acting along the circumference or along the diameter. These are the aromars suggesting that the internal pressure is acting along the diameter. Now, we are having D is the diameter of the cylinder and T is the thickness of the cylinder. The resistance forces are offered by the material at its edges. We have to calculate that what is the bursting force and what is the resistance force. So bursting force is nothing but that is the pressure force. We know that pressure is equal to force by area. So force is equal to pressure into area. So from the above, if we'll see the top view, we will see that there is a rectangular surface is obtained. The internal surface of the cylinder will shown as a rectangle one, where D is the diameter, and L is the length. So we can find out the area of rectangle as D into L. Now pressure force is equal to P into area, that is P into D into L. The resistance offered by the edges of the cylinder. So at the edges, T is the thickness and L is the length of the cylinder. We are having two rectangles are there. For one rectangle, what is the area? So this is T into L. So we are having two edges. So total area will be equal to 2 into T into L. The resistance offered by the material will be equal to stress into area. So stress is nothing but sigma c into area 2 into t into l. Now ll cancel out. Now sigma c is equal to pd into 2t. So in this way we are getting the value of circumferential stress is equal to sigma c, that is equal to pd by 2t, where p is the internal pressure, d is the diameter, internal diameter of the cylinder, and t is the thickness of the cylinder. So circumferential stress is acting along the diameter of the cylinder. Thank you.